whole mission was part of the effort to figure out how to extend the ability to use autonomous underwater vehicles, AUVs, to do exploration missions in the deep ocean. Why icebergs? Well, this project actually was funded by NASA. And the reason NASA cares about going out and studying something like icebergs is they're interested in developing and demonstrating technologies that could support the search for extraterrestrial life on remote worlds like under the ice and on the Jovian moon Europa, or maybe even circumnavigating asteroids. From their perspective, an iceberg, you can think about it as an asteroid. It happens to be white, it happens to be floating and spinning around one axis, but it's very much the same kind of a mission. It's an extreme environment with an autonomous vehicle with interested scientists trying to map and explore this remote body. One of the things we were trying to do in this project was move to map vertical surfaces like deep canyon walls to develop control implementations, technologies that would allow us to fly safely along a complex vertical terrain. We have to fly parallel to the iceberg surface, and the iceberg surface is changing its shape. Now, to make all this possible, we developed what we called the Iceberg AUV, which is very similar to the Dorado-class AUV that MBARI currently uses to generate seafloor bathymetry. But the big changes that we had to make is we had to outfit that vehicle with obstacle-avoidance sonars. These obstacle-avoidance sonars are aligned in the horizontal plane. The second thing we had to do was mount our mapping sonar. So the vehicle has a second sonar on it, which is aligned in the vertical plane, looking out the left side of the vehicle as the vehicle is driving forward. So the obstacle avoidance sonar just makes sure we don't run into anything. The vertical sonar is actually what collects the science data that tells us what that surface looks like. This whole expedition was extremely successful as a technology demonstrator mission to show that all the technologies we had developed to perform these missions did in fact work. The obstacle avoidance, the wall following, the mapping, all of this, even with the moving terrain, worked. We actually ran several repeat missions on three different icebergs. We came home with a lot of data. We're still processing the data, but things went well.